My name is Chip McNeil. I'm the chair of Jazz Studies here at the University of Illinois. And tonight we have the Latin Jazz Ensemble, and we're really happy that you're all here and found your way down here in the basement of Smith. And we're going to put on some great music for you. We've got a lot of excellent solos, and we're going to let them stretch out a little bit tonight. I think we're going to do just one a little longer set, as this turns out. We had a really long set last night. Two sets, actually. We have a lot of music for the concert jazz band, but thanks to all of you that turned out or watched on the stream last night. We are streaming all of the jazz concerts as we do our forums from here every Friday from 1 to 2. So you can tune in. Tomorrow we'll have another concert at 3. I'll just run them down real quickly. The Brazilian Jazz Ensemble will be in here from 3 to 5 tomorrow. If you can be here, great. If you can't, please check it out on Jazz at Illinois on YouTube or Facebook. That would be great. And then tomorrow night we have the Jazz Vocal Ensemble under the direction of Dr. Barrington Coleman and the two jazz vocal combos. So there will be a lot of vocal jazz tomorrow night, and that's at 7:30, and that will be streamed as well. Monday night we're dark, nothing on Monday, and then Tuesday the Repertory Jazz Orchestra under the direction of Jim Pugh will be over in Cranert at Studio Theater with some dancers. They have a whole special program for you, so check that out, and that will be streamed as well. And then Wednesday we'll be back here for our second of the two combo concerts, and we'll have three of our small groups playing for you right from here, and that will be streamed, and that's at 7:30. So please check all that out if you can, or tell your friends and family or anybody that might be interested in jazz and listening to some great music to go on the stream and check it out. Jazz at Illinois. All right. Well, we're just going to get started, and hopefully you'll enjoy all the music. This first tune is a tune done by a trumpeter that I actually worked with years ago in New York. His name is Mike Mossman, very talented trumpet player and writer, arranger, composer, and he did this piece that's kind of basically a homage to a great Cuban bassist named Mario Bauza, and this is called Cubauza. Cubauza. Thank you. Zambalza. How about a hand for our soloist, Matthew Hamilton on the baritone saxophone. Nicholas Chaplin on the trumpet here at Puppets on trumpet solo. And starting out with a nice tenor solo on the beginning, how about a hand for Sky Juniger on the tenor. All right. Yeah, that's a great chart. Mike Mossman is a really fine writer in the Latin jazz category. Does a great job. He's a fine jazz trumpet player all around, but great writer. That's a really cool chart. Mario Bauza, if you ever want to look him up, was a very famous Cuban jazz bassist and was kind of at the forefront of Cuban jazz for many, many years in the 40s and 50s. And even a little bit later, he lived into the 60s. This next one, we're going to slow down a little bit, and we're going to feature our vocalist, Belle Sander. How about a hand for Belle? Belle has been a little under the weather, so she's going to sit while she sings at her request. So that's the reason she's sitting. And I've been a little under the weather. I've had a kidney stone. I had surgery two nights ago. So yeah, I'm here doing my best. And Belle is doing her best, too. So we're a little under the weather, but we're going to make it anyway. Yeah! This is a chart. I don't know, actually, does anybody remember who wrote this chart? I can't remember. But the tune is by Gloria Estefan, who I worked for 2 years ago when I lived in Miami, when she was first starting with Miami Sound Machine. And this is a tune of Gloria's called Mi Tierra, and we're going to feature Belle Sander and several other people in the band. So how about a hand for that? And this is Mi Tierra.
Oh,
round of hands for Bill Sander. And all the Spanish. Thank you. Great job, man. How about a hand for Nick Kaplan on the trumpet back there? And on baritone again, Matthew Hamilton. You can never do too many baritone solos. That's my motto. I love the baritone. They never get the do. All right, we'll have Belle come back in a little bit and do some more for you. Thank you, Belle. That was great. Gloria would be proud, wherever she is, whatever she's doing. All right. I want to give mention to my colleague, my incredibly talented and valuable colleague, Mr. Dr. Pat Harbison, who's a wonderful jazz trumpet player. He took over this year, as you know, Tito Carrillo, who had been our jazz trumpet teacher for 17 years, left to go back to his home state of Texas. He got a job down there, and I think just wanted to be closer to his family, his wife's family, and certainly understandable. And we're sorry to see him go, and we miss him, but I was really fortunate. I didn't know what kind of happened at the end of a spring semester, and we were like, uh-oh, now what are we going to do? So I got on the phone and talked to some people, and I had just seen a thing where Pat had retired. Pat was the jazz trumpet teacher at Indiana University for 30 years, I believe. Long time. And I played with Pat on different gigs and things, and it's just a wonderful musician and a great educator. And I immediately thought, well, you know, he's retiring. He just retired, but I thought, I'm going to give him a call and just see. You never know. Sometimes people want to ease out of it. And as it turned out, it worked out wonderfully, and Pat agreed to come over and be our interim jazz trumpet teacher for this year and maybe next year, we hope, and until we can do a search and hopefully get a full-time jazz trumpet teacher. And he has a lot of experience with Latin jazz as well, so it was great. He stepped in, and we basically have been co-rehearsing this group all this semester, and it's worked out great. And I know Pat wishes he could be here, but he lives over near Louisville, Kentucky, and comes up in the middle of the week, so he couldn't be here for the concert. But Pat, I hope you're watching out there. I hope I did justice to you. That was one of the tunes that Pat rehearsed with the band. So we split up about half the tunes I rehearsed and about half he rehearsed. This next one is also one that Pat rehearsed with the group throughout the semester. This is called Blim Blim Blim. This is a great old tune by Chano Pozo, who was one of the founding members of basically Latin jazz and Cuban jazz in America. Chano was a great conguero and percussionist in Cuba and was discovered basically by the late great Dizzy Gillespie. And when Dizzy would go to Cuba back in the 40s and 50s, before all the revolution and all that stuff, he ran into Chano and met all these wonderful Cuban musicians. And Chano was one of the ones that decided to immigrate to the United States and came to New York. And so he had a wonderful, great Latin jazz orchestra, one of the first in New York at the time, back in the 40s. And this is a tune of Chambo's. It's a rumba. This arrangement is done by somebody I know a little bit. I don't know him personally that much, but I have played with him and met him a few times. When I was on the road with the great Arturo Sandoval, we did a lot of Latin jazz concerts and all over the place and played a lot of venues. And this gentleman, Hilario Duran, who's a wonderful jazz pianist and Latin jazz pianist and has written a lot of great arrangements, as you'll hear, this one is one of his. So he did this really fine arrangement of Blim Blim Blim, which is a rumba by Chano Pozo. So Blim Blim Blim. All right. Oh, up front, I forgot to say. We're gonna have a little moment for our pianist over here. And he's directly from Cuba, and you can tell by his name, Jimmy Suharski. Jimmy is going to be featured on this, so piano at the front. Thank you. The Hamilton. Well, you're. Are you twins?
Yeah.
You are twins. Oh, okay. I didn't know. You're not identical twins.
Yeah, we are. Yeah.
You are. Wow. No. Do they look exactly identical to me?
Yes.
You have lots of subtle little differences. Anyway, the Hamilton, Matthew and Nate. They did a great job. They're coming in, and both freshmen too.
Yeah.
So doing a great job. How about a hand for both of them? We're going to slow things down and quiet down a little bit. And we're going to bring back up our lovely and talented vocalist, Miss Belle Sonder. How about a hand for Belle? And Belle is all the way from Austin, Texas, I believe, right? Yeah, there you go. She's a Texan. So the Spanish is something you hear a lot, I'm sure, in Austin. Yeah, okay, that's good. Well, we're going to do something that's actually a little different. This is a Brazilian tune. This is by a tune by a great jazz, just a Brazilian percussionist and singer, composer, arranger, Milton Nascimento. And I remember we did this, one of our former students here, Marcelo Comungian, who's a Brazilian, great jazz Brazilian pianist, who was here, got his doctorate here several years ago. And Marcelo has relatives who are also in jazz and Brazilian music. And he wrote this chart. I believe this was, I mentioned this last night too. We did a chart of mine, a chart on a Toninho Horta tune, Beijo Partido, for a concert that we did with a Brazilian vocalist that we brought here in combination with the Lehman Center several years ago. This was pre-COVID, I believe, probably 2016 or 17. Her name was Livia Nevstrovsky. And Marcelo also did some charts for that. He was on the band at the time, on the concert jazz band at that time, playing piano. And so, being a Brazilian, he knew of Livia. She's kind of a pop star in Brazil, but a really fine singer, jazz singer too. And so he did this chart for her, actually. And tonight, we're going to get Belle Sonder's rendering of it. And this is like I said, a Milton Nascimento tune entitled Vera Cruz. Vera Cruz.
Okay.
Hoje foi que a perdi, mas onde já não sei, me levo para o amar.
Thank you. Jim. All right, how about a hand also on that beautiful trombone solo by Kyle Hunt. How about a hand for Kyle on the trombone? And how about again on alto, Nick Hamilton on the alto solo. Chop break for a second before we dive into the next tune. I spent many years playing on the road with lots of different bands, but a lot of Latin, a lot of time with Arturo Sandoval and a lot of different Latin bands too. And with played with many great people from Tito Puente to Celia Cruz, and recorded with a lot of them as well. And one of the things that I wanted to impress upon this particular group as we've rehearsed throughout the semester was that, and they're learning tonight, I can tell. On Latin gigs, typically when you have solos and stuff, they are quite long. They can go on for a long, long time. And you have to learn how to pace yourself a little bit and take material and figure out different ways to use it and reuse it. And so one of the things we talked about was just taking your time developing something as a soloist. So I'm really hearing some of that tonight from all of you guys, and that's good. I'm making you do it by giving you some space. We play a lot of other charts and a lot of other ensembles where there are a lot of ensemble parts, and there are in these charts as well. But the solo space is really the main thing in this music, and keeping the energy up all the way through. It takes a lot of energy to play this music, and it's wonderful music, and I want to get that experience to these young students. They're doing a great job, too. All right, the next tune we're going to do is another one that that my colleague Pat Harbison rehearsed with this band. And this is a wonderful tune by a guy we just lost a year or so ago, Chick Corea, the great, like, great Armando Chick Corea. Wonderful jazz pianist and composer and arranger as well. And this is one of his more famous and well-known tunes entitled La Fiesta. And it was kind of a big hit in jazz back in the 70s when he first came out with it. And so a lot of bands kind of emulated it and came up with their own versions of it. And this is one particular version that was done by a wonderful trumpet player named Tony Klatka, who was actually on the Woody Herman band with my colleague, Jim Pugh. I was on Woody's band later, but we continued to play this chart. I'm sure Jim probably was on the recording of this chart. And so we're going to do the Tony Clacka version of Chicoria's La Fiesta.
Thank you.
Skylar Juniper. Sky Juniper on the tenor. And over there on the piano, playing the part of Andy DeBerg, is on the recording, Jimmy Kaharski. La Fiesta. All right, we're going to turn things down just a little bit in terms of the volume and play a great old jazz standard that's been put to a little different treatment. A very good friend of mine, great trombonist up in the Chicagoland area, Tom Garling. He and I went to school together years and years ago at the University of Miami, and then I actually hired Tom to take my place when I left Maynard Ferguson's band to be the musical director and conductor and writer and ranger, because he was a terrific ranger. He is a terrific ranger and writer. And he wrote this really nice vocal chart. We're going to feature Belle Sander again on this. And this is on a great old Rodgers and Hart, American Songbook Writers tune entitled My Romance, and it's a little bit different treatment. And we're going to feature Belle and several different people in the band, My Romance, arranged by Tom Garling.
Thank you.
Sticking around for us. Like I said, we've got a couple more for you. I really want to introduce the band at this point and give them a little break. So once again, overall, starting the rhythm section, how about a hand for Jimmy Saharsky on the piano. And our jazz bass teaching assistant, Eli Narragon, as our timbalist or timbalero tonight. There we go, the timbalero. There we go. And back there on electric bass, and he's also a fine acoustic bass player as well. How about Mr. Sam Olson on the bass? And back on the drums, I want to say one thing about this young gentleman, Chris Morrow. He's been recovering from a dislocated, what is it, right shoulder? Yeah, so this whole band is kind of the walking wounded, I think, between Bell and myself and Chris. How about a hand for Chris Morrow on the drum set? The saxophones on my right here, I guess, would be Sky Juniger on the tenor, Nick Hamilton on the alto, Matthew Hamilton on the baritone saxophone. And the trombones over here, how about a hand for Peter Korda on the trombone, Kyle Hunt, and Jerry Min. Holding down the trombone section, doing a great job. And how about a hand back there for Nick Kaplan, our jazz trumpet teaching assistant, Nick Kaplan. Kevin Kierski, I'm sorry. And Hannah, I forgot your last name. What is it?
Merrick.
Hannah Merrick on the trombone. Thank you, Hannah. Sorry. Kevin and Hannah are new faces for me, so I'm still learning. Thank you, guys. The whole band. How about a hand for the whole band? Yeah. You did a great job. It's difficult when you go from one conductor to two different conductors doing different things. So I thought it worked out really well, and I'm glad the students got the benefit of Pat's expertise and hopefully a little bit from me. All right, we're going to forge ahead now, and we have a couple more. Like I said, we did one Chick Corea piece earlier, La Fiesta. We're going to do another one of his. This is called Armando's Rumba. Ooh. Okay. This is a chart by Mike Tomorrow, who's a really fine saxophone player and arranger. And we're going to do this Armando's Rumba because his name was Armando, really. Armando Chick was a nickname. And but everybody called him Chick Corea. But anyway, this is Armando's Rumba. It's a really beautiful tune of his too, by the way, and this is a great chart. And we're just going to feature a couple of the other people in the band, Armando's Rumba.
Thank you.
Leo Trumba. How about a hand for Sky Dinniger on the tenor? And Nick Kaplan on the trumpet back there. All right. All right, well, we come to that point of the evening where we're going to have to say goodbye in a minute. We have one more for you. This one goes back and harkens back a long way in the tradition of Latin jazz, arranged by a great musician named Ray Santos. This goes back into the book, basically, of Tito Puente. And this is called Sonny Ray, and... Well, we'll just play it for you. We have a multitude of solos that we're going to play on this, but this is a real traditional Latin jazz type piece. And we've had a real ball playing for you. Once again, the U of I Latin Jazz Ensemble. It was fun to play for you, and we get to stretch out a little bit, and we hope you have a really pleasant rest of the weekend. Like I said, please come back or tune in on the stream, Jazz at Illinois. We'll be back here tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock with the Jazz Brazilian Ensemble. And then at 7:30, the Jazz Vocal Ensembles and Vocal Combos. So make sure you check that out, please. All right, here we go with Sonny Ray.
Thank you.
Cheers. And the whole U of I Latin jazz ensemble, stand up, take a bow. I'm going to have the Bell Sander doing our vocals. The U of I Latin jazz ensemble, thank you guys for coming out. We appreciate you finding your way over here. And we'll hope to see you tomorrow at the next set of concerts. Great job, guys, again.